Clap your hands like this. Young people, I need y'all to come right down here in front of the stage.
Good afternoon, motivation, and welcome to the online worship experience. You are officially a digital disciple. So glad that you came to join us. I am Terrell, and this is
Nakia.
And what about that word last week? Wasn't it amazing?
Amazing. Gary, applaud to you.
Just meeting us in the middle. Yes. Just wonderful. Still raving reviews about what an awesome word. Just a few house rules before we transition into worship, and I'll let Nakia take that over.
Let me take it away. Three things, guys. Come on in. I need you to listen closely. I need you to like. I need you to comment. And I need you to share this video. We are a hollaback church, so the hearts are the new hallelujah. So let's get to clicking.
And because sharing is caring.
Yes.
Hello.
Okay. So we are ready to go into the word in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's time to give God praise. Come on, I need you to stand on your feet where you are and begin to shout unto God. Come on, lift him up. He's been great to us. Come on, he's still a good God. Come on, put your hands together. I need you to put your hands together. Hey, there we go.
More and more,
we're chasing more and more.
Say.
I'm chasing after you.
We're gonna praise our way.
I'm praising my way through.
Just to be close.
Closer
and we're chasing after you, yeah. Come on, lift it. I'm chasing after you, say. We want more of your presence, God, we are. No matter what's going on, I want to be, I need to be. I'm chasing after your presence, God.
More and more, say.
Father, we need more and more, say.
More and more.
Father, we want more and more,
yeah. More and more.
Nothing but your presence will do. We want you more, say.
More and more.
Give us more of you, say. Give us more of you. We want you
more.
Give us more of you. We need you. We're crying and we're desperate for you. We want to
more,
say. More and more. Come on, call out to them. More and more. Sing it out. We're chasing after you, yeah. Now praise him right here. Give him glory. Nothing else will do, God. We're chasing after you. Nothing else will do. We're chasing after you. Nothing else. I'm chasing after you. We're praising our way through just to be closer to you. We're chasing after you. Can we sing it together one more time? I'm chasing after you. We're gonna brave. No matter what's going on, I wanna be closer and we're chasing after you, yeah. Come on, let's sing it again. Give me some breaks. I'm chasing after. We're gonna praise our way, sir. Just to be close. Hey. We're chasing after you, yeah. More and more.
More and more.
More and more. We're running for more and more. More and more. Come on, can you lift your hands and just call them on? Sing more and more. Come on, call them on. We need more of you. We want
more.
Your presence that changes, renews, and restores. We want you more. Your presence that changes, renews, and restores. We want you
more.
Come on, his presence that changes, it renews, it restores. Come on, lift your voice. Presence changes us. Your presence will renew us. Yes, God, in your presence restore. So we need more, yeah. More and more. We want you more.
Hallelujah.
to you.
Yes, Lord.
Said my hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, can we sing it together, one voice? Shout it.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
You deserve it.
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 Glory.
Every ounce of worship, it's all about you. Oh!
All of the glory belongs to you.
All of the glory, Lord. Yes.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Come on, shout it.
Hallelujah.
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 worship belongs to you. All praise belongs to you. We take the time to worship you. Hey, to worship you. We take the time to worship. Come on, hallelujah. Sing hallelujah.
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 Sing all the glory.
All the glory.
All the honor.
All the honor.
All the praise.
All the praise.
Yeah, yeah. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. You deserve it.
You deserve it.
Worship Him, you
deserve.
Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. I won't let the rock cry out.
You deserve.
You deserve. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to you. Worthy, worthy Lamb, yeah. Worthy, worthy Lamb, yeah. Hallelujah. Worthy God. Praise the Lord to a mighty one. Holy, holy. The angels cry. Holy, holy. The angels cry. Holy, holy. The angels cry. Holy, holy, the angels cry. Holy, holy, yeah, yeah, yeah. Holy, holy, I'm gonna say it. Holy, holy. Holy, holy, I'm gonna show. Holy, holy, yeah, yeah, yeah. Holy, holy, I'm gonna see that. Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
The angels cry. The angels cry.
Holy, holy.
The angels cry.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
Holy,
holy. Holy, holy.
Holy, holy. Holy, holy, I praise my way, I worship my way, I praise my way, I'll cry holy, 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 we'll praise our way, we'll praise our way.
You deserve it, babe. You deserve every ounce of worship we give you.
Hey guys, it's Robin. I'm here to welcome you to our Motivation Online experience. Before we do anything else, let's take a minute and pray together. Let's bow our heads together and pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we're so grateful and thankful for who you are, God. We thank you for what you've already done in this place, God, for your presence in this place. We thank you, God, for being mighty and awesome, Lord. We ask you, God, to touch each and every person in their houses, wherever they are right now, God. We ask you to just share your love with them, God. Shower them with your love, Lord God, so that they can feel it, Lord God, and it will change them from the inside out, Lord. We thank you, God, for what you're doing and for what you're going to continue to do. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Again, I just want to welcome you to our Motivation Online experience. We're grateful that you joined us here today. If it's your first time here with us, why don't you put a 1 in the comments below? We just want to give you a special shout out. for being with us for the first time. We know you're not here by accident and that God ordered your steps to this place. And where our hope is that you will experience something with God that will change you from the inside out. So stay tuned and I'll see you guys again.
God is doing some amazing things here at Motivation Church. Over the past week, as you know, we've had the opportunity to continue to be generous. We did it in two big ways last week. Number one, we, in partnership with the Patriots, we were able to work with some new partners and make sure we fed the community. It was such an amazing day, and thank you to Gary and Shelly who did the work to make that happen. We continue to meet the needs of our community during this COVID pandemic. It's amazing what God is doing. But here's another thing that we were able to do. Because of the potential riots, not just here in Randolph, but also in our neighboring town, Brockton, there was a little bit of chaos. Y'all seen on the news that took place. And so one of the brothers called me and said, Pastor Jay, let's do this. Let's get out in the community. Let's serve the needs of the community. I'll give my time and my talent. And so we went on Facebook and we let everybody know we're boarding up places, helping houses. If you have a building or business that was in trouble, we're gonna board it up and for free. Man, people started calling and wanting to donate and help us do this in our community, and it was such a blessing. Thank God not everybody needed it, but at the end of the day, it was the act of kindness and the act of service that we performed because of the generosity of the people of this church and the community that we were able to continue to serve the needs of people. So this is what I'm asking you to do. Every month, we have something called I Commit. Motivators, y'all know what I'm talking about. But we do this every month where we give once a month on top of our tithe and offering. It's a special giving opportunity that we give and we commit to so that we can continue to do the work. The Bible says that money answers all things. If you ain't got no money, you ain't got no answers. So what I want you to know is that we serve God, not money. But God uses money to help us serve the needs in our community. And so I'm gonna ask you on the 28th of June, the last Sunday of June for I Commit, here's what we need. We're coming back to the building September 6th. We're coming back to the building. And what I need you to do, we need some more chairs. This place is getting packed out. We need to buy some more chairs. So this is what I need. I need 75 people that are willing to commit on the 28th to buying one chair, at least one chair. I need 75 people to commit to at least buying one chair. Each chair costs $35. My wife and I are gonna be the first one, so that's two chairs right now. Two chairs, so we need 73 more people to join us in buying at least one chair. You can just go ahead in the comments and put one chair in your name, and our team will get back to you. We'll make sure we reach out to you so that we can count you in the number so that we can get some more chairs, because we're getting ready to worship together again. It's gonna be lit. But also, as we're giving today, I know you're ready to give your tithe and your offering. The Bible says bring all the tithe and the offering into the house of God. We know that tithing is part of how we worship God. We don't just worship God with songs, which is the fruit of our lips, but we also worship God with the fruit of our labor. So we're getting ready to give, and I love the fact that we're a generous church. I've been talking enough, so y'all get ready. Get your tithe, get your offering, however you give. We got our everything right there for you can see it. It's been up, but anyway, you can see it. Come on, lift your seed and say this with me. Y'all know what to say. With this seed, I'm expecting a great harvest in your kingdom and in my life. I know y'all ready to say it again. Y'all just started without me. Come on, let's say it. Lord, with this seed, I'm expecting a great harvest in your kingdom and in my life. Listen, guys, thank you so much for your generosity. Thank you for giving. Thank you for loving God and loving our church and loving our community. And I can't wait to give you a testimony of some of the great things ahead. I'll talk to you in a minute. Blessings.
Hey, Motivation. It's Jaden, and these are your Motivation news and announcements.
Hey Motivation, my name's Anne Janique and it's graduation season. Join us June 28th for Motivate You Next Steps graduation.
Hey guys, we're gearing up for round two. That's right, backed by popular demand, small groups. We're starting Wednesday, July 8th from 7:30 to 8:30 It'll be a 4-week session, and we're so excited to start it up again. This is how you sign up. You email groups@motivationchurch.org, and we will get back to you with a Google form. You have to fill out that form for us to get you in a group. After that, your group leader will contact you and let you know what group you're in. The purpose of these groups is that we all come together and learn more about God together in a small group setting. It gives us a chance to connect with one another, and it's especially important now that we haven't seen each other for so long. It gives us a chance to connect and keep close to one another. Registration is between June 21st and July 5th. Make sure you sign up. We want to see you there.
Hi guys, this is Miss Jodine. I want to thank you for tuning in every Sunday at 11 a.m. for Kids Church. If you haven't had an opportunity to see the videos, don't worry. You can catch the replays along with lesson plans, videos, and coloring pages all uploaded to Motivators Connect. So stay tuned for all of our new content every Sunday, 11 a.m. See you later.
If you're interested in joining Motivation Church, please type Motivate Me in the comments so we know who you are and we can reach out to get you connected. The COVID countdown begins now. That's right, we are planning on opening our doors Sunday, September 6th. Make sure to set your clocks, mark your calendars, because we are getting ready!
Yes, Lord!
Also, we're still continuing to do big things to motivate our community. Please make sure to follow us on all our social medias, including Facebook, Instagram, and also YouTube, so you can keep up with what's happening. Well, I guess that was it. Once again, I'm Jaden, and those are your Motivation News and Announcements. I'm out.
Good afternoon, everybody. Come on, I'm so glad that you've joined us at Motivation Church today. I know that God has been doing some amazing things all afternoon long, or whatever time it is while you're watching this, but we're so grateful and appreciative of the presence of God and your presence. We know that God led you here. He ordered your steps, and you are hanging with us today because God is good. He's faithful. He's amazing. And I'm so appreciative that I am a part of a church that does some amazing things. And because of the hard work of the staff and everybody who serves and leads at this church, we're able to be online and stream and minister to you right where you are. So I'm glad that you're tuning in, that you're here with us. We are, this is crazy, we're in week 9. Oh, week 9 of our What Now series. And before I even get into this message, let me tell you this. Last week, God spoke so powerfully through Gary Ratliff. I know his word, God's word to us through him was life-changing. It was destiny-altering. It was edifying. It was encouraging. It was all of that and a bag of chips for the old school saints. And I just want you to know that I'm so proud of what God is doing through the people of God that are connected to Motivation Church. And so having a week off, having some time off felt great because I had a little bit more time to think through and think clear. And you know, the condition that our world is in right now, we've been dealing with a pandemic, a global pandemic, but we've also been dealing with, you know, racism and riots and all these things over the past 2 weeks. And I know that people's head and heart is all over the place with what is going on. And I think with all of this tension, there's no other time like this time when we just need a word. Anybody need to hear from God today? Come on. If you need to hear from the Lord, you need a word from the Lord, go ahead and just click those hearts right there, because you know hearts are the new hallelujah. And I want you to go ahead and show some love, because We're getting ready to get into this word. And I know somebody needs this right now. Somebody needed to tune in and get connected and be encouraged. And so I want to minister to you today. And before I get into the word, can I pray with you really quickly? Come on, let's just pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for another day and another opportunity to be in your presence. God, we're standing and sitting with great expectation, not only of what you're going to speak into our lives, but what you're going to do in our lives. God, we thank you for the hope that we have that only comes through Jesus Christ. And we pray that whatever it is that we came into this experience carrying, that we'll leave out better than when we came in. God, we love you and we thank you for all that you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, y'all, listen, we have to get into this word because I only got a few minutes with you. But I believe that God is doing something and saying something, and I want us to tap in. All right. And I told y'all, some of y'all are new, some of y'all don't know. But 90% of people who take notes when I preach go to heaven. So you're going to need to write some stuff down because I promise you, you're going to need this. Let's look at this. Let's get our Bibles ready. And I want you to go to Isaiah chapter 40. Go ahead and get Isaiah chapter 40. And I want to kind of give you a precursor because this series, this What Now series has been powerful. And it's been really focused on three big things: the pain of the cross, the process of the believer, and the promise of the Holy Spirit. It's very important to understand that. The pain of the cross, the promise, the process of the believer, and the promise of the Holy Spirit. And the foundational thought that we've been sharing, like the undercurrent, the thing that's really been the driving force for this series, is that Jesus did a whole lot with us and for us. But he gives us the Holy Spirit so that he can do everything through us. And so that's really the driving force behind this. And when you understand this simple yet powerful point, it causes you to have a greater dependency on him. And what is a Christian life without dependency on Jesus? We shared something in Bible study. And let me say this, if you have not been tuned in and tapped in to what is going on at Connect Bible Study, man, listen, you are missing everything. If you don't get to Bible study, you don't know what you're missing. Pastor Mel Kirkland has been doing a phenomenal job teaching and preaching this series we call Prayer Series, helping to take our understanding of prayer and maturity in prayer to a whole nother level. And y'all know that we're on, that we had a conversation towards the end of the teaching, and God really started putting on my heart the word Waze. And we are talking about God's ways. And I think about the app, you know, the app Waze, W-A-Z-E. And the app Waze, one of the things about that, it gives you directions. It's like MapQuest used to be. And it's like Google Maps. You know, you put in the direction you're trying to go. You put in the destination you're trying to go. And it gives you directions based on where you are and where you're trying to go. And I was sharing how God, through his word and through the power of the Holy Spirit and the person of the Holy Spirit, he gives us a map. He gives us direction through his ways. Yeah. And so because God does this, I shared about how I was in New York. And I was trying to get somewhere, and I'm a little bit familiar with certain areas. And I was down in Manhattan. I was trying to get to this gym. And because I didn't want to wait in traffic, even though I had the directions of and the destination of where I was going in the app, I decided that I didn't want to follow the directions. And so I jump out of this long line and I fly around traffic and I'm moving for about 2 minutes. Then all of a sudden, I hit this street trying to go my own way. And boom, guess what happened? They added 9 more minutes to my time of arrival because I didn't follow the directions through the Waze app. And it's quite often that when we decide to go our own way, and we decide to do things the way that we want to do it, in our timing, in our process, and through our patterns, and through our own way of figuring this thing out called life, what happens is we get to our destination that God wants us to get to. It's just the process begins to change. And I want to help somebody because right where you are, you're going through some stuff right now. And I want to say this because we've been We've been quarantined and isolated for 3 months, and some of us right now, we're on the verge of coming out. Yeah, the world's opening up again. You know, in Massachusetts, our governor, great Governor Baker, he's given us his four phases of his plan, and now we've entered phase two, and people are getting ready to go back outside again, and all of that good stuff, and we're getting ready to come out. But I want to help you, because even though we're getting ready to come out, we're still not close enough that we're not feeling the effects of what it's been like to be isolated. And this text that we're getting into today is rich of this. So let's go to Isaiah chapter 40, verse 29 through 31. We're going to read from the NLT. Thank you, Kyrie. He has that on the screen for us. Isaiah chapter 40, 29 through 31. When you got it, come on, just type, I'm ready. Oh, yeah, I see y'all right there. Y'all ready today with your Bibles. Okay, he says, he gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even the youths will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings, here it is, like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Let's look at verse number 30 one more time, because I know y'all read that with me, and some of y'all was waiting because the way I said it, you didn't really feel it, but I'm going to say it in the way that you feel it so you get it. So when you get it, you'll feel it, and when you feel it, you'll get it. Y'all got it. So check it out. In verse 31, it says, but those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. Okay, that was too new school. In the old school, King James, it says, and those that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. Today, I want to preach part 9 of this series, What Now? I want to preach from the subject, His Ways Work. His ways work. Y'all see it there. It's not a typo. His ways work. Since COVID came, COVID messed some things up because it canceled some stuff. It changed our agenda. And one of the things that happened when COVID hit, I was so mad because it was my birthday week. I turned 20 for the second time and I was getting ready to celebrate, had a party planned, and boom, COVID hit, had to cancel my party. But it wasn't just my party, wasn't just the gym, wasn't just some of the plans I had. It was also the fact that they started shutting down airlines. So now I'm frustrated. I had to call JetBlue, cancel a whole bunch of flights, and they gave me what they call travel bank points. So the other night I was on the phone and I was like, you know, I got to see where my travel bank points are because I want to start planning for some future trips. I need to see how much credit I have in my travel bank. And so I couldn't get in because I forgot my password. So I had to call JetBlue. JetBlue has me on hold 45 minutes. Oh my God, the pain of waiting. You know that traffic is demonic. You know sitting on the phone waiting on hold is demonic too. So I'm on hold, I'm waiting. And while I'm sitting there waiting to get on the call, I'm getting frustrated because it's taking so long. I got frustrated. You ever get so frustrated? You're like, I'm about to hang up. But every time you're about to hang up, they play some more elevating music and you think they're answering. Anyway, they're playing me. And so I'm getting ready to hang up. But as I'm sitting there and I'm thinking about the necessity of the call and I'm thinking about what I needed to access and how long I've already been waiting, I realized something and it changed my perspective while I was on hold. Although time passed, although I waited much longer than I expected, I was getting frustrated. But watch this. I was closer than I was before. I want to come at y'all a little bit different today because you don't have to wait till the end of the message to shout. You don't have to wait till the end of the message to throw your phone and have a praise break in your living room. You don't have to wait till we come back to church on September 6th. What I want you to understand is right now, the word for you is you're closer than you were before. And somebody ought to pause and give God praise because you're closer than you've ever been. And I don't know what you getting closer to, but some of y'all been working on some dreams. Some of you have been working on some goals. Some of you have been planning some things, and it seemed like COVID came to
take some things out. When the Lord said, I'm going to allow COVID to expedite the process. And what you thought you were going to lose, God's getting ready to use to bless you. And you are closer than you've ever been. Somebody ought to praise God right there. Let me slow down because we got to go. And I want to give you some things because I don't want y'all just to be popcorn Christians shouting all the time. You need to get some stuff in your spirit. But I want you to see this because the prophet Isaiah, he's writing to God's people during what I would like to call a biblical pandemic. It's a very interesting time because now these people are in captivity. They're now dealing with issues because of Babylon and all these surrounding cities trying to overwhelm them and overtake them, and now they're losing everything. Israel and Judah, they're losing their identity, they're losing their resources, they're losing everything that's meaningful to them because of a personal pandemic. They've lost their place with God. They're starting to lose their position. They know who God is personally. They know his name. They know his power. They know what he's able to do. But because of what they're going through, they had a hard time trusting and believing God. So now they start doubting what they know. Oh my God. Sometimes when we have hard moments, isn't it funny how the devil will allow things to look a certain way so you can start doubting what you know? They're doubting it, and now they're in the midst of trouble. They're in the midst of being overwhelmed. They're in their own quarantine because they're isolated and they're overwhelmed and they're taken captive by a whole nother group of people. There's a system that's in place that's overwhelming them, and literally the system has its knee on their neck. I hope y'all see this. And so now that they can't breathe, now that they're overwhelmed, they're sitting and they're asking themselves, God, where are you in all of this? And while they're in the middle of going through all this, God sends a prophet by the name of Isaiah, and he tells him, I want you to give my people a word. I want you to tell them that they have to know that God's ways work. I know it doesn't sound good. I know it's not popular. I know some people don't want to hear it right now. They're rioting. They're protesting. They're angry. They're putting up statuses. They're shooting at people. They're doing all kinds of things. But can I tell somebody who has an ear to hear, who needs something to feed their soul, that God's ways work? And in church, here's the thing. We often quote this scripture. We love saying, and those that wait upon the Lord, they'll renew their strength. They'll mount up with wings like eagles. And I love it because it's good. It's true. What the Bible says is right. We love to talk about how eagles fly. But before we go there, can I take a moment to talk about how eagles die? Oh, we don't like this. Yeah, I want to talk about how eagles die, because I've learned something with God, that before there's a resurrection, there must be a crucifixion. There's a moment that you have to take up your own cross. There's a moment that you have to surrender and submit and say, not my will, but your will be done. And I've learned something. I studied just a little bit, and I studied something about eagles. The eagle is the longest living species. The bald eagle is the longest living species of eagles. And it lives up between 70 and 100 years. But here's the thing. The eagle has to do something that I never hear people talk about. The eagle has to make a hard choice in order to grow. Because between the age of 30 and 50, the eagle does a couple of things. Check this out. The eagle has to fly to a high place, sheltered from the sun, where water is present, so that it can endure. He has to go into quarantine. He has to go into isolation. He has to go to a quiet, secret place so that he can go through the process of change. Its body is so, watch this, when it goes into quarantine, his body becomes so overgrown with feathers that the wings can't move as well as it wants to. He can't fly fast. He can't do all the things he used to do because of the weight of the feathers. I hope y'all with me. And the thing is, he has to go to a place so that he can go through a process of becoming. The Bible also talks about this because when Isaiah compares us to this eagle, he now does something that we have to pay attention to. When he compares us to the eagle, he said he will mount up with wings as an eagle. Oh my God, catch this. So he says, when he does this comparative analysis, what he shows us is that there's something that the eagle experiences. And we love seeing the eagle fly, but he never gives note about how the eagle dies. And I want to help somebody, because when the eagle is dying, he's dying to his old self. He's dying to his old level. He's dying to what he used to be. And he goes to a private place so that he can begin to pluck its talents from its feet. He goes to a place so he can isolate, so that his beak can be broken against a rock. Sometimes God has to take us to a private place so that we can rediscover who we are and be developed into who he's calling us to be. And the first thing I need you to write down, I got to give you these and we got to go. The first thing I need you to write down is God is demanded wherever you're depleted. Oh my God, you got to catch this. God is demanded wherever you're depleted. And let me say it like this. God is the supply who supplies, who supplies, who supplies you. Yeah, God supplies, who supplies, who supplies, who supplies you. God is the supplier. And in verse 29, he tells us he gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even the youth will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. Here's the thing I love about this, because he says the youth, young. He's not necessarily talking about children and kids, but what he's trying to pull out and give us this understanding, as the Bible says in 1 John 2:14, that he calls the young. Why? Because they're strong. So youth, when we read it there, it represents vitality. It represents strength. It represents health. It represents life. So he's, other words, what he's saying to us is, he says, even where you were strong, you will become weak. Even the places you were strong and had energy, you will get exhausted. I hope y'all catch this. So now God has to supply us with power, because we can't depend on our own power. Because even like the eagle, when the eagle is going through a metamorphosis, the eagle is at a place where he's not operating in power, he's operating in weakness, and he needs a place to rest so that growth can happen. And maybe these past 3 months, you thought it was a death sentence. You thought it was the worst time of your whole life. I know you've had some loss. I know you've had some moments. I know you've had some brokenness. I know you've had some disappointments. But could it be that what God was trying to do in your life is bring you to a place of rest? Because some of us, if truth be told, some of us don't rest. Some of us have to be forced into rest. And God says, I'm going to bring you to a place so that you can rest, so that you can be redeveloped and you can be rediscovered. So who I'm calling you to be, you can become. And this is the thing. When we start seeing ourselves get weak in places where we were strong, it usually becomes the place where we make premature decisions, where we make bad decisions and bad choices. Because now when we see that we don't have strength anymore, now then when we see those areas of our life that we're not totally in control of anymore, we start to recognize and realize our need for God in a different way. And maybe God has given us this urgency to push in the What Now series, because we need the Holy Spirit. We need him to come in an undeniable way and breakthrough in our lives. The Holy Spirit comes so that we can do what he's called us to do, and we can't rely on our own strength. God is demanded wherever you're depleted. Here's the second thing. We got to hurry up before we go. Here's the second thing. You get watered in the waiting. You get watered in the waiting. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. I hope you caught this. Those that trust in the Lord will find new strength. Those, King James, that wait. Just type that. Wait. 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 Because God's ways require us to have patience. Yeah, come on, Holy Spirit. That's why the Bible says in Galatians 5 that the fruit of the Spirit is what? Come on, let's pull them up. There's love, there's joy, there's peace. What's number four? Here it is. Patience. Oh, yeah. Patience. We'll read the rest. Patience. 5, kindness. 6, goodness. 7, faithfulness. 8, gentleness. Number 9, self-control. We'll get into those, but I need you to understand, we need patience. In order for God to water you in the waiting, you have to have patience. And the only way we're going to have patience to endure is to trust the Holy Spirit in the middle of suffering. Because suffering is the scent of the saint. And every person who follows the Lord, they have the scent of suffering on them. Because at some point in your life, you're going to go through a season that you do not have what you want. It doesn't feel good. You don't even know where God is. But that is the place where God is. God is right in the place of your worst moment when it seems like you're not going to get through, when it seems like you're not going to overcome, when it seems like you're not going to make it. How do I know God is there? Because I ain't dead yet. Yeah, somebody ought to praise God, right? Did you die? Come on, because you got to understand the evidence of the glory of God and the favor of God in your life is not just when everything's good. It's not just when you get the check. It's not just when Bay shows up. It's not just when you eat all you want and still lose weight. No, the evidence of the favor of God in your life is also when you did what other people did, but you didn't die. When you did what other people did, but you didn't get addicted. When you did what other people did and you didn't get locked up. Somebody ought to give God praise right now because his favor, oh God, his favor is on you. Come on, somebody type that. Favor, favor, favor. He waters you while you're waiting. Watch this. When the eagle is going through the waiting process, he has to go hide in a secret place on a rock. And when he hides in a high secret place on a rock, here's what I love when I read this. It said that the eagle, when he's going through, other eagles are flying around. They're not near him, but they're close enough to hear him cry. Because if the eagle is in a place where he's hurting and hungry, they make sure that he goes through his process properly, and they'll fly down and deliver some food, Uber Eats. They'll make sure that he has everything he needs. Oh, God, can I help somebody? And I want to excuse the world. Please, world, excuse me for a moment. But this is a motivation moment. I want to talk to every motivator. I want to talk to every person who's a part of Motivation Church. And I want to tell you, that's the real reason that God's got you connected. Because you're not going to do life alone. You're not in this by yourself. And when you cry out, it's not just God responding, but it's your family responding. It's your church family responding, because we are our brother's keeper. We have the responsibility to hold each other up and care for each other when we're going through. God says that you're watered in the waiting. 450 days, the eagle drinks water and waits until its feathers, its beak, and its talons grow back. Your relationships in this season are a major key, because you're going to need some friends to feed you. Oh my God. Yeah, you're not meant to do this alone. because you got to recognize what God wants to do in your life. He connects through your community. And so you have to make sure you have the right circle of people around you so that when you're crying, oh God, they'll start flying. Oh my God, can I help somebody? When you know that somebody's really connected, is that when you're crying, they're flying. They're making sure you're safe. They're making sure you're covered. They're making sure you're fed. Aren't you glad that you're a part of a church who can fly while you cry? I know that. I was a rapper in my former life. Please forgive me. But you got to know that I want to grow you here because I'm not talking about surface level stuff. I'm not talking about people that give you a ride to work. I'm not talking about people that give you a couple dollars for lunch and, you know, because you could buy your own lunch. You get your own ride. I need somebody that won't let me quit God. Oh, God, let me say that again. Y'all missed that. I need some friends that won't let me quit God when I feel like it. I need some people who will pray me out of hell. Oh God, can I remix it? And I need some friends that will pray the hell out of me. Oh, you weren't ready for that. You need some friends. You need somebody that will pray for you like it's their own life, like it's their own situation. You need some people that won't allow you to die until you reach your destiny with God. Do I got some friends? Come on, just go ahead. Thank you, Aaliyah. Tell me you're not somebody. You got to recognize that what God wants to do in your life is connected to your circle and cycle of friends and those that wait on God. When you trust his ways, your life increases. Here's the third thing. We got to go. Got a couple minutes. I got to give you this. Point number three, got to write this down. God's ways work. Here's number three. He will grow you to go you. I know it sounds crazy. May not make sense yet, but I got you. He says, in verse 31, part B, he says, they will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Mine up with wings as eagles, run, not get weary, walk and not faint. Y'all catch that? I don't know. Soar high, fly high on wings like eagles, run, not get weary, walk, not faint. Fly, run, walk. Fly, run, walk. Fly, run, walk. Fly, run, walk. Fly. Okay, y'all got it. Fly, run, walk. All of this, he gives this definitive kind of perspective of God's view for the church. His call on your life is to grow you so he can go you. In other words, all of this is designed to mobilize you. I know y'all missed that, but check it out. You're slow but worth waiting for, because you do know that one of the things that the pandemic has done, especially in the church, that it's taught pastors and leaders how to do ministry independent from a building. Oh my God. And what I learned and what I love is that God never just said come. Yes, we need to come to the house of God. We need to come here and serve and praise and worship and give and sow and love and teach and build and be edified. But Jesus said, after you do all of that, I want you to go. Come on, somebody, just put it on the screen real big. Go. Y'all see it in my hand? Go. Thank you, Kyrie. Go. Yeah, he says, go into the world. Go teach all nations. Go baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I want you to understand that God grows you through process so he can go you into promise. And some of you don't understand, why is this so hard? Why is this so heavy? Why does it seem like it's taking so long? Because the harder he pulls you, the further you're going. And God is trying to grow you, not just go you. He wants to grow you first, so when you get there, you won't forget what it took for you to get there. When people want to do something quick, they can go by themselves, but when they want to take a journey, journey and they want to know that they're going to be in this thing for the long run, they have to look back to their roots and they have to see where things have been established. And God takes you through process so that he can bring you to a place where you don't forget him when you get there. God's sending you on, oh yes, Lord, on assignment. The eagle's wings, let me hurry up. The eagle's wings become larger and stronger than ever. But here's the note that I wrote down that I really love. When the eagle's going through this process, his wings get stronger. He starts plucking out the old wings. His beak comes off. Talons come off. He's walking around looking crazy. But after a minute, he starts growing his feathers back. His beak gets restored. His talons come. But here's what he gets for surviving the process. Y'all ready? It says that when the eagle begins to grow again and his feathers and beak and talons come back, it also says that there's an oil sac that grows over the heart of the eagle. I hope y'all caught this. There's an oil sac that grows over the heart, over the chest of the eagle. And then once everything begins to grow back, the oil breaks. The sac with the oil breaks. And when the sac with the oil breaks, the oil begins to strengthen the wings, the talon, and the beak of the eagle. And I want to tell somebody that I don't care what you thought you lost. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care how hard it's been. There's an anointing coming. Let's go to church. There's something coming on the other side of what you're going through right now. And can I tell you, you're not just a survivor, but you're an overcomer. There's a fresh anointing that's coming over your life, that's coming over your family, that's coming over your career, that's coming over your vision, that's coming over your dream, that's coming over everything that you do. Come on, somebody shout, I'll wait for you, Lord. I'll wait, because when I trust God's ways, when I trust God's ways, I'm following his direction. Here it is, though, but I'm open for his inspection. I'm allowing God to do a work in me, not just on me. See, when I just go through the steps, I look like a Christian. I sound like a Christian. But when I allow God to take me through a process, I can live it when I don't like it. And God's ways work. What now? What now is, God, I need you now. I need God more than ever. I need the Holy Spirit to come and start plucking some unnecessary things, some things that used to carry me. Because you know, the wings had feathers and the feathers allowed that bird to fly. But without the feathers, that bird couldn't fly. So what used to carry me can't carry me in this season. God's going to give me something new. I need some things to be plucked. The beak had to fall off. The beak was the place where he would peck at things. He would get fed. He would use to feed himself. Maybe God's trying to change the place of dependency. Those that wait upon the Lord, the talons, they were like fingernails. Their talons, they would be on the feet of the eagle. That's what they would grab things with. Maybe God is trying to change what you're going after. Maybe God's trying to shift you. He's trying to grow you so he can go you. I want to help you, and I'm going to pray for you in the last 35 seconds. I want to help you, because there's some of you right now, you're like, Pastor, I hear you, but it's hard, man. You don't know what I lost in this season. You don't know who I lost in this season. I don't even know how to trust God again, because this last season was tough, and I get it. I feel you. We've all had some losses. Israel, Judah, They were in a tough place because they were captive. They were held captive by something they once had control over. Now it had control over them. Once where they had strength and power, now this thing had strength and power over them. But I love what Paul reminds us of. 2 Corinthians, he tells us, he says, when I'm weak, God is strong. So I don't need to be strong. I can boast in my weakness. And I want to tell somebody, this process for you to trust God's ways work, that I need you to understand this one thing, that I have to be vulnerable with him. I have to open up my heart to the Lord and give him permission, give him access into the secret places of my heart. And this isn't just about non-Christians getting saved. Now understand, the writer is giving a view of two things. One, he's saying that Israel will be saved, that God is saving them, that he wants to deliver them. That's what he does. But it's also a glimpse of salvation through what they're going through. It's a two for one. And so I want you to know this, that as we come to this close and before we pray, God's saying, I want to save you. I want to save your soul. And I want to deliver you from your trouble. So whether you're someone who's a sinner in need of a savior, or someone who's saved and you're in trouble, God is just. He's able to forgive. He's also able to rescue you. And if that's you, right where you are, if you want to give your life to Jesus, I'm going to do two prayers. If you want to give your life to Jesus, just do this with me right now. Just bow your head and say this with me. Say, Lord, please forgive me for all of my sins. I recognize that I'm a sinner in need of a savior. And I thank you for accepting me just as I am. I believe that Jesus is Lord, that he died for my sins and he rose from the dead. And because of this, I'm saved, I'm healed, I'm whole, and I'm new in Jesus' name. And for the other people that are saved, I want to tell you that you're not alone. And the Bible tells us that we have a God that he responds to the cry of his people. So God, I thank you for your people today, that whatever weight, whatever burdens, whatever things they're carrying, whatever's overwhelming them, I pray that they'll learn to trust you again, that they'll take a step knowing that you're not a man that you can lie, and you don't make mistakes, so you don't need to repent. You don't need to apologize. God, you can do anything but fail. So Lord, I pray that you would intervene, that they would see your hand, that they would see your faithfulness. And God, you would birth a praise out of a painful place. Thank you, and we praise you in Jesus' name. Listen, guys, so grateful that you joined us today. There's so much more, but we'll be back next week. I want you to tune in, tap in this week, Wednesday night, Bible study, prayer life. It's going to be amazing. Don't forget, God's ways work. I see you guys again this week. God bless you, everybody.
Thank you guys for joining us on our motivation experience. We are just so happy that you are here. And honey, wasn't that word amazing? Pastor Jay, he is just on fire. And it's just as amazing always to get this word. Even though we're at home, we are still able to be reached. So Terrell is going to tell you a few things.
Listen, as we're leaving, make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Yes. Share the gospel. Somebody may want to become a digital disciple. Though we can't be together physically, we have everything that you need online platforms, safe and 6 feet apart.
Yes, and we need you to follow us, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. Do not forget, sharing is caring. So we will see you next week. Have a great day.
See you later.
All right, guys. So listen, today was great. Man, y'all are crazy. Y'all are wonderful. Y'all are just so good at this. I don't know. But I want you guys to know that God continues to do great things through Motivation Church. Our prayer, our hope, our desire is that you are blessed by everything that we give you and serve you as ministry for motivation.
And if you do not have a church home, I want you to be a part. If you want to become a member, you want to become part of Motivation Church, just say motivator right there on the screen. Go ahead, type motivator, and somebody on our staff will get in touch with you. We want to make sure that we connect and get you connected, because we know that God is doing some great things, and this is just the beginning. I hope that this word blessed you. I hope that this word encouraged you, empowered you, and gave you enough gas to keep on going and keep on moving. But before we leave, you know, in true motivation form, we gotta do this. Come on, this week is gonna be the greatest week of your entire life. It sounds so good, we should say it again. Come on, this week is gonna be the greatest week of your entire life. There's gonna be checks in the mail. There's gonna be bills paid off. You're gonna eat healthy and unhealthy, and still you're gonna look good when this week is over. I'm prophesying that to you. Anyway, do me a favor, tell somebody, say, I pray that God keeps you and covers you and continues to bless you until we meet again, in Jesus' name. God bless you, everybody.